Hey guys, so here we have a great crossing bell at the layout, in the Golden Gate layout. So I'm going to show you how that works. Very easy. We have basically photocell sensor right here, basically four of them, one here, one back here, and two back in front of the stations. And what happens is that it detects basically when the train goes in one direction or the other one, and it starts automatically. So if we run the train, you can see the photocell right here. And if I move my train, it's going to start detecting right now. And the second one basically confirms it's right here. That confirms the direction of your movement. And back there, we have another one right here that stops the sound. And we have another one back there. So if I go reverse, there's one photocell right after the crossing here. So that stops the sound. The second one is right there, so that confirms it. And when it reaches the third one here, it knows that the end and it can stop. Under the layout, we have here the gate crossing module. So these wires come from the photocell sensors and they are connected here. Then here, that's the wires to go to the little lights. I put some resistors to limit the current on the lights. Here, you have these extra resistors which are in parallel on each sensor. That's because the sensors we have, they have basically too much resistance. They do between like 300 and like 3 mega ohms or something. But this one wants like a lower resistance. So I put this in parallel. So like this, we don't have too much resistance, and it means it also works when the lights are dimmed out in the layout. And here, this blue wire that comes here, that's the bell module. So this little orange potentiometer, you can use to control the volume. And also these two wires, the blue ones, they go on the other side to a switch so that we can kill the sound if we want to. And now on the front, next to the panel, right here, it's a speaker which I right now stuck in the corner, which mounted properly. And also I've put a switch for the sound right here. Basically, like if you cover one of the sensors, see, and if you turn the switch off, let me do that again. Now you don't have any sound. So you can have sound. Sound. Come on. Detect it. Yeah, sound. And you can cut the sound, like if it gets stuck, if it's too much. Wrong direction. Let's go that way. Stops and going in reverse. It starts right after the crossing back there. And it's going to stop once it reaches the sensor after the crossing. About now. Nothing wrong with this. The main issue is that when you stop on the first sensor, like this one here, so if I stop here, basically what happens is that so it detects this sensor and it's waiting for the other one and it's never coming. So there's a long timeout. If you don't have a choice,
You kill the sound with this switch here. You can put the sound back on, of course. If you continue, so it's going to stop eventually. Okay, so let's wait for the timeout. Okay, that's a really long timeout, and I don't know to make it shorter. Okay, now it stops. So now, if you cover the second sensor, the one which is near the... you get the same effect. So if you get that also, basically you just cut the sound, or if you move, it's going to stop, and I think the timeout is much smaller. Yeah, like this. So you have an issue if you're going very slow like this. So now we trigger the second sensor, and it's basically confused because this module doesn't really know which direction you're going, so it just stops right away. So basically, on the sensors which are near the crossing gate, the delay is short, and the sensors which are far, the delay is long. So like right now, it's going to trigger it again. And because the train is moving, it doesn't really know which direction it's going, so it's just going to do a long delay. So in case you have a very slow moving train, you're going to have a module detect it. So let's back up here. It's going to find the first sensor right after the crossing back there where the fire truck is. Here we go. And as we seen, so the next sensor is basically right there and the next one is here. It's going to make a long delay. If that's really annoying you, we can just hide this sensor here. And should think, oh, you're done crossing, and it stops the sound. So that's a workaround. The problem is that then it's going to do it again here. And again here. And it's going to do it one more time when we reach the next one right here. Okay, so let's see it one more time in normal action, and I'll put it off in the way and clean and turn the layout off.